What is a healthy behavior that people shame others for? Being slow to respond. I would rather respond correctly than quickly. Same for confidence level. If I am unsure, it means I want to double check. It seems more irresponsible to speak off the cuff. But I think the reality is that the fast talkers are rewarded more, even if they are wrong. Interesting note here. Back when we were playing Among Us, I noticed that the first person to talk in a dispute is usually who everyone sided with. Talking fast usually meant you could get away with a flat-out lie, once at least. Doing things that are normally thought of as social activities by yourself, like eating at a restaurant, or going to a concert, play, or movie, I was going to say, but TBH I don't think people care or notice at all. Stop shaming yourselves for enjoying life, friends. Being wrong. It's healthy to express opinions and ideas. When we shame people for being wrong, we tend to stop new conversations from happening. In this way, we lose opportunities to understand where others are coming from and squander opportunities to change minds. Further, we push all the wrong-headed people into groups where they can go nuts following their wrongness to its logical conclusion. Just stop humiliating people for holding opinions and having bad ideas, and remember everybody does. I dad admitting you're wrong, or that you fricked up, to this. Too often accepting blame is seen as either a weakness or a reason to lay into someone, when it's actually a sign of integrity. Being single. I had this horrible experience where I wanted to be single for a bit and also just wasn't meeting anyone I was really interested in. I was perfectly fine with not having a boyfriend, but my friends hounded me about it constantly, always asking me why I was single, telling me I was too picky, would show up to hangouts with men and ask me why I didn't go for it. Me saying I was fine with being single was never a good enough answer, so I started to feel self-conscious about being single, felt like I was under a microscope, so if I did meet someone I felt uncomfortable having my friends cheering me on. I was young so I didn't know how to handle it, so I just kind of dealt with it, but it sucked. Let your single friends be single unless they are asking for your help, advice and opinions. I'm a single guy at 31, and this get a girlfriend things annoys the heck out of me. I wouldn't pass up the chance if I met the right person, but I'm pretty happy being single. Prioritizing your mental health. It's such a high expectation on people to expect to be constantly working and seeing who can sleep the least, while at the same time maintaining the perfect home family appearance. It's all an illusion and careful editing presented on social media to make you feel even worse about yourself. Though we've made progress in talking about mental health, there's still a lot of stigma around it, and many people either can't afford the help they need or have to be on months-long waiting lists which can find an appointment being offered too late. It's such an underfunded area, and I just hope that in the future we can work to a lifestyle with clear boundaries between work and home, and that when people need help and support that they can actually get it without having to worry about the money waiting time's stigma. Spending time alone. Seriously, you think me spending a week talking to nobody is the issue? How about the fact that you can't spend 5 minutes alone in fear of accidentally reflecting upon yourself? My family doesn't think I should cook or clean and that my wife should do it all, as it was in their dysfunctional marriages. Everyone always talks about how mom's cooking is always better, and that is generally the stereotype, but my mom's cooking was pretty bad mostly. My dad, on the other hand, could have opened a restaurant. As a man, using sunblock. I can't even tell you how many times I've been heckled on the golf course for putting sunblock on my face before being out in the sun for the next 4-5 hours. Talking to a therapist regularly. It's a purchase of time to help work through complex emotional issues in order to have more bandwidth in other areas. It's good for all regardless of mental state. Asking about kids early on in the relationship. I'm not saying you should ask on the first date, but why is it so frowned upon? Shouldn't you go ahead and find out if you want the same things in life before you're 3 years into the relationship and the breakup will be 10x worse because you waited till it was too late and it hurts like heck? I think heavy communication early on should be encouraged. From the moment you know you're interested enough that you could see yourself with that person long term, make sure you're compatible. Children, finances, religion, politics and all the things that can trip your relationship up in the future if you haven't resolved them in the early stages. As a dude, having a routine for my face at night, which is weird because my guy friends have faces too, so I'm not sure where the shame comes from. Not taking business calls after work hours. Everyone should take Portugal's example and pass some sort of law against it. I used to lie and say I wasn't home or was busy. Then I realized it's my own time and I'm not being paid for it. So I'd just be truthful. We need you to work on a Saturday to finish this report that's delayed through no fault of your sorry. I'm having a movie weekend with my sisters and don't want to do it. Not getting into fights with your significant other. Had a friend that tried to convince me that it was unhealthy for my wife and I to not get into fights. I tried to explain that when we disagreed with each other about something, we talked it through and trusted each other enough to listen and be receptive to the other person. She just rolled her eyes and said that it would happen eventually because to her what we were doing was just bottling things up. I couldn't convince her that the reason she got into fights was because she and her husband bottled things up until they exploded and that's why she got into fights. Calling in for a mental health day. There's no good option. You call out and make yourself look unreliable, or you go to work unstable and make yourself look unstable. I would call in sick. Not a lie, a mental sickness is simply a sickness. This ensured I could handle the work pressure despite so many issues. However, I was extremely privileged that my work offered few days per year for calling sick without a doctor's notice. I got laughed at by my brother and his wife during Thanksgiving when I said I was starting to diet. Like, I get it, I'm a fat guy. Unfortunately, I can exercise, but that's only half the battle. It actually really hurt my motivation, NGL. It's okay, we're right behind you. Frick em. Sleeping in, going to bed early and waking early is revered, while getting the same amount of sleep just shifted back a few hours is lazy or irresponsible. The world is not made for night owls and it sucks. Being polite and non-confrontation. There are people who see this as a sign of weakness and will take advantage, abuse those who aren't buttholes. Having a mutually respectful relationship with my husband's ex-wife and treating my stepchildren with respect, and they treat me with respect. I don't see similar situations very often. My stepkid's mom and I have a great relationship. I know it's definitely not the norm. I've heard some horror stories, but I've never felt shamed for my relationship with her. Setting boundaries. It's surprising how many people think you are a butthole or too sensitive for letting someone know they crossed a line. Not doing drugs, including alcohol. I used to be a huge stoner, lost a bunch of friends when I quit smoking weed. Every time I tell someone that I don't smoke weed because of personal reasons, they always pry and try to tell me to try a different strain or Delta 8. Honey, I've tried everything you can think of weed-wise. I don't want to do it anymore and it sucks being told that I don't know how to have fun when weed genuinely led me down a bad path to other harder drugs. I don't judge anyone for what they do and I want people to stop judging me for being sober. Congratulations on your sobriety and frick anyone who doesn't support you on it. I bet you barrels of fun. I don't know if this is just a me thing, but experimenting with creative interests at a young age. I mean, like experimenting with writing stuff and making drawings and your own ideas or for stories you like at a young age. I can only think specifically of a few examples. Undertale fandom. FNAF fandom. In my opinion, it's okay as a child to make dumb or cringe things when you're at that age. Obviously it's going to be bad, it's all about learning your interests and getting better at it. I just hate those sad types of people or trolls that call other things cringe and hate on them because it's bad when they most likely know a child made that out of passion or an interest for something and hope someone at least likes it. How depressed must you be to gain satisfaction or even bothering to hate on something a child made trying new things showing it on the internet? Maybe I'm missing something or I haven't worded it quite right, but I just generally hate when stuff like this happens. Alright, we get it. A child made something cringe. So what? Why does that matter? It doesn't even need to be a child. Everyone can do that what he is passionate about. Politely and respectfully expressing negativity. Bottling negative emotions just for the sake of being positive really eats you up over time. Taking medication for depression. I have been in situations where I have sat and listened to people talking about how they would never take medications. I have had depression since I was 8. 41 years of struggles, and it is offensive and it hurts when people do that. Frick all of you for judging. Imbipolar and so is my mom. She never got help though and instead self-medicates with alcohol. She's now 69 and losing her ever-loving mind. Can't handle her lows at all. Has actual screaming tantrums like a 2-year-old. Keep taking your meds and be healthy. Oh, and my mom shames both my depression and meds. Cutting out people who were unhealthy for you, particularly family. There seems to be this idea of you should forgive family easily when sometimes that's not the right course of action. Maybe that's just because I'm estranged from a parent, for good reason, and I keep seeing opinion pieces on how terrible the youth are for cutting out their parents because their feelings got hurt or something. I don't owe anyone an explanation. My life is just much improved without a parent I don't talk to. Feeling your feelings. No matter what age you are, no one is allowed to just feel their feelings because it might be inconvenient for other people to be around. I'm not talking about just feeling sad or upset, but even really excited. Taking breaks from constantly communicating. People love throwing down that ghosting card when they haven't heard from someone in a day. Nobody needs to keep saying things for the sake of keeping a conversation going every hour. Otherwise, someone is going to get sick of you and really do start ghosting you for prolonged periods. When people who are blind or partially blind are learning to find their way around, many will instinctively snap their fingers, click their tongues, or make some other tapping sound. They are almost always discouraged from doing this because it's disruptive. But Daniel Kish, who has been completely blind since he was 13 months old, was not discouraged, and is now an expert in human echolocation. He can get around without any assistance, seeing the way bats do. From Wikipedia, MRI brain scans were taken of Kish and another echolocation expert to identify the parts of the brain involved in echolocation, with reading suggesting that brain structures that process visual information in sighted people process echo information in blind echolocation experts. Most people think you're weird if you're a man who's not interested in having anything intimate with anyone. Sorry, but I like not having drama. Same if you don't drink alcohol. Like screw your ulcer. People get so weird about someone not drinking. I was on some pretty heavy pain meds for a while that didn't interact well with alcohol. Drinking literally could have killed me. I can't count the number of times I was told to stop being a pee or some other such bulls. Lost a few friends over it. Sorry, I wanted to remain alive, buttholes. Human sexuality. All through high school my mom was all stay away from boys. They only want one thing and they'll say anything to get it. Don't be one of those foolish girls who gets tricked and knocked up and has her life ruined. No parties. No dating. No makeup. I wasn't even allowed to talk about guys being cute without her side-eyeing me. Then I go to college and halfway through freshman year she's like, why don't you have a BF? Get out there. Meet someone. Why aren't you more social? And put some makeup on. She meant well, but it was very confusing. To this day I'm shy around guys I like because of that woman. Escapism. In whatever form, just needing to forget about life for a while. Could be gaming, reading, cinema, even booze and drugs. As long as it's in moderation. It's not irresponsible, it's very healthy. There's a sad irony to this where someone will shame someone for their escapism habit and then do something that serves the exact same purpose. This is different, though no the frick it's not. This is how you cope with life just like everyone else on the planet. Declining invitations to hang out or socialize because you need your space to recharge and be alone. It doesn't make you flaky or rude. It just means you understand, value, and prioritize your own needs. There's a stigma out there that looks down at people who need their alone time, and it forces people to come up with little white lies to get out of socializing. It shouldn't be this way. Walking away from an argument or tense situation. There's no way I can have a proper and productive discussion if I'm wound up. I'd rather take a quick walk or have time to myself before I tackle the issue. A clear head is more important than figuring out a conflict quickly. Ordering a glass of water at restaurants, cafes. I don't really like sodas so I prefer water, but I don't want to add to the mountains of plastic bottle waste when the same water is flowing from the tap. Also, 0.5 liters water is not enough, but 1 liter is too much. A glass is the perfect amount. choosing not to have kids if you don't feel like you'd be a good happy parent or be able to support them emotionally, mentally, financially, socially. Like, I don't think I really want kids because I don't think it would be good for me. I wouldn't be super happy as a mom. I'm on my way to full financial stability, but I won't even consider it until I'm there. My mom keeps pushing me to have a kid even though I still drive an 08 piece of crap, rent, and have $60,000 student loans. Like, I'm not there. My kid is gonna have to go without like I did, and I personally don't want to actively try to have a kid so they can go without. If I did change my mind, I would want to make sure they had a really fulfilling life. My mom had me because she wanted a kid. She got knocked up by a dude that didn't want me, so I grew up without a dad. She was a poor alcoholic. I grew up crap and hated most of my childhood. I don't want to be selfish like her and inflict that on a kid just because I wanted a kid. Not eating sugary products or junk food. I've been told I'm dumb by my siblings for being boring, for not constantly eating junk like them. I guess they will see who is dumb when they get the health issues. Exercise. You would be surprised how many people make fun of me for going to the gym. Having muscles relegates me to being nothing but a dumb jock when I actually hold a master's degree and am extremely successful in my sector. You just gotta feel bad for people like that. The fact that you are keeping yourself in shape probably makes them feel bad about the fact that they aren't, so they cope by making fun. Self-care. Whether that's taking yourself out for a nice meal, getting an early night, or watching some dumb show that makes you happy. This is a difficult world. If something makes you feel better and doesn't hurt anyone else, then you never should never feel bad for doing it. Staying home from work while sick. Though fortunately, I think that's going to become a thing of the past on account of the pandemic. Showing emotions, specifically for men. People shame men for crying, general sadness, getting visibly excited, basically feeling any emotion other than anger or neutrality. You're supposed to express your emotions, that's why you have them. Just make sure you're not hurting yourself or someone else in the way you express them and you'll be fine. Taking a break. Having boundaries. Shaming usually by people who don't have boundaries. Having a proper work-life balance. You're not working hard enough. Assessing what is too much to tackle and allowing the necessary space to do it properly in order to avoid burnout. Again, shamed as not working hard enough, or fast enough. Taking it slow is shamed. People tend to value overworking, saying yes to everything, accomplishing a ton in a short amount of time, etc. If you know your boundaries and what your mental and physical health can and can't handle, your boundaries are often shamed. Saying no to going out. Whether it's to save money, health reasons, or someone just doesn't want to, it's completely healthy to just stay in when you want to. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.